depending on your perspective, Devin Nunes just did or one of two things, either he just threw down the gauntlet, or just shouted out a federally sized dare you to former FBI Director James Comey. Either way, the Republican legislator from California's Central Valley just pulled the ex-director of the FBI's punk card. In the immortal words of Scooby-Doo, "Ruh-ro." In an interview with Fox News' Brett Baier on Friday, Nunes blasted Comey's previous testimony to Congress and, in the words of a hard-hitting article from Jim Hoft of the Gateway Pundit, challenged the former FBI chief to come back to Congress and testify under oath again. Nunes is basically daring Comey to reappear on Capitol Hill and explain, under oath, why he apparently lied to, misled Congress in the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Court. As chairman of a House committee, Nunes could conceivably subpoena Comey to come back and testify. And that could trap Comey in a situation where a perjury charge could well be waiting in the wings. Check out what Nunes had to say, from a transcript of the Baier-Nunes interview in a tweet from author and academic Andrew Bostom. Trending, foul play, billionaire couple linked to Clinton Foundation found dead under mysterious circumstances. Nunes' words are crystal clear. In a related story, former CBS News investigative reporter Cheryl Atkinson wrote a piece for The Hill reporting the FBI, specifically, James Comey, very well may have violated the strict protocol that is involved in a Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Court warrant. As Atkinson noted, there are strict rules requiring that each and every fact presented in an FBI request to electronically spy on a U.S. citizen be extreme vetted for accuracy, and presented to the court only if verified. Whoops! Someone just may have set themselves up for a perjury charge. In what may generate even more eyebrows raised, Atkinson again correctly cites quite the bombshell, there's no dispute that at least some, if not a great deal, of information in the anti-Trump Steele dossier was unverified or false. Former FBI Director James Comey testified as much himself before a Senate committee in June 2017. Comey repeatedly referred to salacious and unverified material in the dossier, which turned out to be paid political opposition research against Donald Trump funded first by Republicans, then by the Democratic National Committee and the Hillary Clinton campaign. Sadly, Comey may fail to realize that none of this would be an issue if he'd just done the right thing from the get-go. Related, Assange pulls rug from under Comey, exposes ex-FBI dear.s schizophrenia. Watch Nunes' entire interview with Baier here. Nunes' challenge to Comey comes about the 9-minute mark, but the whole thing is worth watching. It's going to be interesting to see if Comey takes Nunes up on that dare. And if he doesn't, it's going to be even more interesting to see how Democrats try to spin it. Please comment on Facebook and Twitter, especially if you appreciate the newfound manhood recently rediscovered by a number of Republicans in D.C. What do you think Comey's response to Nunes' dare will be? Scroll down to comment below.